If you can't remember a shortcut in Obsidian, all you have to do is press Command or Control P. This will bring up the command palette and you just have to search whatever it is you're looking for. Let's say we want to insert template. It tells us right here the shortcut is Command T. We can also press Enter to get the template. Or let's say you want to add a checkbox. And all you have to do is Command L or press Enter and it will give you the checkbox. And even for commands that don't have any shortcuts or hotkeys assigned to them, you can still use them in the command palette here. Let's say exporting this to a PDF, all you have to do is press and it'll take you to the command of exporting your note into a PDF. This is one of my top time-saving, mental space-saving shortcuts, and we're just getting started. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Vicky. I use Zettelkasten in Obsidian to take my notes and go from input to output. And today, let's talk about all the frustrating times when you have an idea, your mind is racing, but you can't find the right shortcuts to do the things that you want to do. So let's cover the 10 must-know shortcuts in Obsidian. We already covered number one, which was Command P, trying to find the right commands and finding the shortcuts in the first place. The second shortcut, and is one I use almost every time before I start a new note, is Command or Control O. And what this does is it searches through all the titles of your notes. Now, of course, you can just, you know, try to find a note that you're looking for, but actually I use it before I start a new note because I want to make sure I haven't written about something similar to it previously. For example, I am reading The Stone Reader. It's basically just a column or a collection of articles on the New York Times about modern philosophy. And so before I take a note for this book, I just want to, you know, quickly check what types of notes have I done already on philosophy. As your vault grows, this is a really quick and easy way to make sure that you are building on previous ideas. And it's also a quick refresher to see what you've already written about. So when you actually create the note, you already are thinking about, okay, what's related to this new idea? What already exists in my current vault? Now, let's say, okay, I now see I've done a few things, but actually this current note, I want to call it, what is modern philosophy? I don't have any notes named this. The really helpful thing in Control or Command O is that you can just enter to create the note if it doesn't already exist. So let's just do that. And here we go. We have our note created. What is modern philosophy? Once we have our note created, the next one I want to talk about is Command or Control T. Insert template. I know this is super basic, but it's one that saves a lot of time, so you don't have to recreate the same things you always type out. And so for me, for an idea, I use the idea compass. If you haven't seen this, go into this video here to learn about the basics. But at its core, it's just to stretch an idea to see what's happening. Let's say the idea I want to explore here is, with the internet, we have exponentially increased our ability to converse with people holding different points of views. And what I find really interesting is actually translations are, you know, having slightly different interpretations of the same original idea. And this reveals interesting ways of thinking and communicating ideas. Let's say that, you know, this is something I want to explore under modern philosophy. And here brings me to the next shortcut I want to use, which is within the notes that we take, because we want to keep them atomic. If there's an idea that we want to expand, but not within this one note, what we can do is just highlight it and press double brackets. And this way it becomes a note right away. And all we have to do in order to expand on the idea is just to press Command and click the note, and it becomes a new note. All right, let's move on to the next set of shortcuts, which are to navigate the tabs we have. So, of course, you can click with your mouse, but the more tabs you have, the easier it is to just use Command Shift and either open square bracket to move backwards or close the bracket to move forward. After navigating between tabs, we also want to know how to close and open them, right? So Command W, very simply, closes a tab. And if you think, oh crap, I didn't mean to close that tab, it's okay, you can undo the closed tab by pressing Command Shift T. This way it'll come back again. Now this brings me to the next pain point I have. I don't know about you, but at least in my workflow, I'm working on a bunch of ideas and then sometimes I think, oh, actually I need to go back to this file that I recently did. I don't really want to recall what I titled it. I don't really want to sift through all the tabs because, to be honest, like, I usually have more than two open. So in order to find those files really quickly, the next thing I want to share is recent files. So I already have it open here, actually. It's under this clock icon, and it shows me all of the recent files I've been working on. And disclaimer, this shortcut, even though I have it, let me just show you recent files. I have Control F as my recent file shortcut. But if you don't have the plugin, it won't work. So what you have to do if you don't have recent files plugin installed is go to Community Plugins, Browse Plugins, type in recent files. You'll see it here. And then once you install it, you have to add the hotkeys yourself. So what I did was to use Control F as a way of surfacing my recent files so that if, let's say I was just in my regular vault and I press Control F, it'll show me the recent files list. Now, the next thing I want to talk about is creating new notes. So of course, it's very intuitive. If we want to get a new note, right, we just press Command N, and very great with the new updates and we get tabs, it just opens in a new tab so our previous tabs don't disappear. That's great. But the other and more powerful shortcuts for creating a new note is actually Command Shift N instead of just Command N. And what this brings up is a separate pane, a new window for the new note. So let's say we are taking notes on the modern philosophy and there's something that came into our mind and we want to at the same time, you know, refer back to one of the notes and take notes on another one. This is the shortcut to use. All right, I lost track. I think there are more than 10 shortcuts here. The next thing is to take all of these things and apply them to your notes. Check out how to make atomic notes if you haven't, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.